Let's start our journey with functions. In functional programming, functions are simply transformations. I like to think of them as pipes. They receive an input and transform them to something else. This yellow pipe transforms any integer it receives to an integer of one unit higher. This one gets an integer and transforms it to the string representation of it. And for the last example, it maps all even integers to true and the rest to false. As we said, the inputs and outputs are actually sets of values. For the yellow pipe, input and output are both sets of integer values. For the Tostring function, input is a set of all integers, and the output is a subset of all strings. For the isEven function, the input is a set of all integers, and the output is a set of Boolean values, which there are only two of them, true and false. We can think of these sets as universes. If we take a closer look to the Tostring function, it maps each of integer values in the left to a string on the right. A function is always defined for every single input it can receive. But as you see here, it doesn't need to cover all the possible values on its output universe. For example, a string, book, is not part of the output of the Tostring function. By the definition, functions can only map a value from input to only one value in the output universe. In other words, you cannot have more than one arrow coming out of a value from the input set. Another way to look at this is, every time that we call a function, we are expecting it to return the same value. We say a function is deterministic if it follows this rule. As a matter of fact, in functional programming, we only care about functions that are deterministic. Then how we can have a random function? We will learn how to deal with these non-deterministic situations later. Functions in functional programming are a bit more restrictive than regular functions that we use daily. For example, JavaScript functions. The first limitation is what we just explained. In functional programming, functions are defined for all their input universe values. Or in other words, functions in functional programming are always total functions. In contrast, a function is called partial if there are some values in their input universe that the function is not defined for them. Like for example, a division function is not defined over division by zero. We will look into how we can solve this challenge in functional programming later. The second challenge is, functions in functional programming should never do side effects. A function is having a side effect if they read or write something outside of the function body, like reading or writing to a file, or interacting with a USB device, or accessing a browser window object, or request something from the network or the internet, or writing to on a console, or read or write to a database. You may ask, then how can we create useful applications if we are not allowed to do side effects? The short answer is, in functional programming, we try our best to keep the body of our functions pure and only have a thin layer outside of our application responsible to do side effects. Think of it like postponing writing to a file by just writing an instruction object with the details about the file and what to write in that file in the function body, and postpone the actual writing till the execution gets to our thin outside layer. Don't worry if this doesn't make much sense now. We will look into how to manage side effects in future lessons. And as you learn and play more with these concepts, these will get more and more clear. I mentioned the term pure function. A pure function is a function that doesn't do side effects and is deterministic and total. And since we are unlisting the functional programming terms and concepts, in functional programming we never mutate and change any values or variables. We only create new values from old ones by doing transformations. This is called immutability. Function purity and immutable data structures lead to a super useful behavior. We can always replace a pure function with its definition, like replacing increase function by its plus one definition. This is called referential transparency and is a huge advantage of functional paradigm over imperative paradigm. Think about testing, optimizations, concurrency, parallelism, and all other benefits this power of replacing things gives us, which we couldn't achieve easily with, for example, object-oriented programming. Alright, enough with all the terms and definitions. Just have this in mind. All this trouble of defining and learning these terms are for our convenience in the long run. So now, with all those assumptions in functional programming, we simply draw a line between our universes without losing any information. The blue arrow is now representing our mapping, which is total, deterministic, and with no side effects. Instead of showing these universes with all their values, let's name them and use their name from now on. Hope you liked this video and I will see you in the next one.